Welcome, painters. Today we're painting Baby Cade from the Malifaux game. I believe he's from the Neverborn faction. Alright, first we start out with the base coat for the skin, and this is usually thinned 1-to-1 with water. And sometimes, depending on what color you're using, it may coat in one try. You might have to layer it on a couple times, but do not go on to the next step until his skin is even. And now we apply the first highlight, and you're going to apply this everywhere except for the deep recesses, the details, like in between his fingers and whatnot. Now we're bringing in the second highlight. Make sure to leave some of that color that we did before. And at the most, cover up like 3/4 of the previous color with this new highlight. And we're not jumping too far into the really bright colors. Like, we didn't jump right into white or anything like that, because skin is usually pretty diffused, just like cloth. So you're not going to have stark highlights unless you want to emphasize that something is wet. Like, if you paint a guy's face and then you do a lot of white highlighting, line highlights like you would on armor, it creates the appearance that they're sweating or their face is shiny. And now we use white, and this is just done as a stark highlight to bring certain things out, the top of the cheekbones, bridge of the nose, little things like that. You're not going to use a lot of it. And now it's time to base coat the bear. And of course, gotta make the bear brown, but you know, you could use whatever color you want. This is also thinned as the other base coat was, about 1:1 with water. And you wanna apply it, except for this time it doesn't have to be completely uniform because we're gonna try to create a texture on him, kind of like we did with Seamus. And so it really doesn't matter if he's not completely brown, all uniform one brown color. So you'll see in the next couple steps, but just base coat it to where he looks decently brown, but don't worry about if there's little patchy spots. Now we throw a little bit of bone white into that mix and start to bring up the highlight. And this is just pretty much the normal highlighting stuff that we do, which is hitting all the areas except for the deep recesses. And as you can see, you want to drag from the mid-tone area up to your highlight whenever you're doing highlights with thinned paint. And this is typically thinned, let's see, probably about 3:1. So if you had, you know, a drop of each of these paints in there, probably want to put 6 drops of water in with that, and your thinning is ready to go. And you're not going to get the highlight to look right on the first time. You'll see me go over a bunch of areas, but you know, do as many as you need to get the highlight to look right. This time we add even more bone white to the mix, and we're just kind of tip-tapping here and there, creating the texture, not making it look like it's a very smooth blend, like the bear's made out of velvet or something. We're making it look like he's kind of fluffy, or trying to make that illusion that he's been through a bit. As you can tell, he's been patched up multiple times, re-sewn together, things like that, so he should be a bit rough. And this is the second final layer of the texturing, even finer dots, making strokes in one direction, things like that. Trying to create a fibrous look. And I mean, I guess you could use a sponge or something like that just to create like random little dots and stuff, but I figure I'll just use the brush this time. Now we start to paint these little pinkish purple areas just to kind of break up that brown and I don't know why pink stood out to me, or kind of like magenta or Warlord purple, which is the paint that I'm actually using here, but I thought it would look pretty cool, so I decided, okay, let's do the inside of the ears, the stomach, and we'll get that 1 foot that's still attached. And now we come in with some pink and do some highlighting. Now, the way I'm highlighting here, I mean, if you don't like the way it's done, you could always do it your own way, but it's not accurate in any way. It's just kind of bringing interest to certain areas. I mean specifically on his little stomach patch there, because it's like, why would the light be hitting that way? Unless I was doing a source of light coming from that direction, which means the model would have to be redone. But it's just kind of like, yeah, you know, when you see the bear head on like that, you kind of want to see some interesting things. So I figured, hey, you know, let's do a blend in this direction. Makes it look a little cool. So that's the only reason for that. And some white was added to the pink in order to make a slightly brighter highlight, and the pink will be done. Now for the button, that is also his eye, I decided to go with a green, more of a turquoise, just to kind of break up the pink and bring some interest to his eye there, and it also kind of complements it, so they both look brighter. And then we apply a highlight to the green, getting the edges of the button and kind of layering it where the light would be hitting it from above, up top, and just that bottom lip of the button. Now for the patch on his arm, I decided, hey, let's paint it blue, just because I don't think everything would be matching if he's been patched up multiple times. So I figure, hey, you know, maybe they found this piece of cloth and they needed to patch him up. So we're doing the base coat here, and we're going to do some little lines on it to make it look like it was a piece of a bag or some trousers or something like that. And two drops of white are added to the base coat color, and we start doing the little lines, and we're just doing horizontal and vertical lines in different thicknesses. And if you're using a tiny brush and you're having problems with the paint drying before you're done actually doing it, try using some drying retarder. I use the stuff from Vallejo. I have to thin it a little bit because it's kind of jelly. And if you use Reaper or anything like that, Reaper's got a very good liquid, almost like water retarder. But that's the trick whenever you're doing fine lines and detail work or freehand stuff, is to use that drying retarder and blow dry it when you're done, and it should dry just as fast as any other paint. Now we're going to bring out some of those threads that are holding this poor beat up bear together. And this is actually just the first color. And now to bring out the edges of those threads, we're using straight white, and also going to hit the area of his left leg that I think the stuffing is supposed to be kind of bursting out of. So make sure to hit the inside of that button, because there's threads holding that button on his face and all those other spots. Because I primed the model black and then did kind of a 45 degree with white, his hair was already shadowed, so I opted to just use some yellow ink for its transparency so it would still show the shadows but colorize his hair. So it's kind of a quick, cheap way to do it. Now Cade's kind of crazy, so I kind of wanted to emphasize that. So I use this Vallejo flesh tone wash and kind of puddle it in his eyes there to kind of give him that you know, he hasn't slept in a while, or, you know, kind of a deranged look. And I apply this into some of the creases in the body to get the shadows to be a little deeper. But you put that around his eyes, let it dry completely, and if you want it darker, you can keep layering it on until it's somewhere you like. But that's what I really wanted him. I mean, he's crazy. He's walking around with a knife and his beat-up teddy bear. He should look pretty sinister. And since the wash kind of tinted his eyeballs, we're going to go ahead and bring him back up with white. And this is where drying retarder is your friend, so you can put the pupils in the eyeballs. I don't want to do irises because, again, you know, he's supposed to be deranged. But if you have a Micron pen that I've used many times before, Sakura Micron pen, you can try that. If he gets googly eyes, you can just, you know, put white over it and try again. And for his knife, we're going to use Vallejo's liquid silver metallic. And these are alcohol-based silvers, or there's a whole line of metallics that they have, and you'll see a couple people on here that use them. But the only fallback, I mean, they're gorgeous. The only fallback I see is when you actually have to shade them in or anything like that, is normal acrylics don't want to flow over them really well. But for this, I decided, hey, let's use it. It's closest to me. So I grabbed it, and here we are. Ah, yes, our good friend Van Dyke Brown is back. And I got a couple questions of, you know, how to thin the stuff and how do you know enough is enough? Well, if you used a wash before, you know what it looks like. You know what the consistency is supposed to be. If you painted onto your model and it turned brown everywhere you painted, it's probably not thin enough. So you play around with it, and it's one of those things you get from experience. It's hard to tell you how much you should thin. Considering how oil paints come out of the tubes, there it's hard to measure that. It's kind of like, well, you get your brush dirty and thin it in mineral spirits and see if that works, and if not, go darker. Play around with it. There's a step missing, as you may see. Right here, we're just shading the knife. You know there's going to be a hard line highlight right on the edge, so in order to make that highlight even more pronounced, just putting a shadow right up below it. That makes sense. Anyways, you can see what I'm doing. But the step that was skipped that you probably noticed if you've seen a couple of my videos is that once the mineral spirits and oil wash is dry, go over it with a matte varnish and then go to this step, because before the oil wash, usually do a gloss just to make cleanup a lot easier, things like that. So here comes my favorite part, which is doing the blood and gore. And, you know, don't use a paint that says blood in the name and think it's going to look like blood, because it never does. And this is a tip for all you guys who want to do some gore, is use a transparent. People use Tamiya Red Clear and mix it with a black acrylic. Or what I'm using here is the Badger Freak Flex, and I use it because Tamiya dries super fast. And this stuff is awesome. So you use the transparent. The transparent looks like blood, but it's not dark enough to look right on our scale. So you use black and you mix it in different ratios so that you can get varying shades of it. So you have something that represents fresh blood. You have stuff that represents like coagulated, dried up blood. And that's what we were doing on the blade there. So I'm just pulling up certain areas with the brush, and then we get some randomizing in using the sponge here. And this is just a blister sponge. You dip it in, dab most of it off on the paper towel, and it kind of randomizes it. And something you'll see here too is I kind of work just up on that left side of him, and I try to get it on his face and stuff, because if you don't, you might have noticed Cade is actually sticking his tongue out of his mouth and kind of licking up on his lip. On his lip, on the left side of his face. So I said, oh, you know, let's put some blood there, like almost like he got blood splashed up on his face and he's licking it, because again, we want him to be disturbed and, you know, kind of crazy. So I made it to where when you're looking at him from the teddy bear side, you don't really see it, but on that side where he's holding the knife, you can see the killer come out. So a little narrative for you. So again, my buddy here on YouTube, Weird Painting, also known as the Digital Coma, did contribute this Malifaux model, as well as a bunch of other ones that are coming. And again, for providing the models, you are awesome. And all these people thank you, as well as myself. So if you guys appreciate the tutorial and you appreciate the guys who are donating the models to this stuff, hit the like button just to let us know. And you know, it's motivation to get another one out. So thanks for watching. And yeah, it wasn't an hour this time, half an hour. So congrats to all you guys that made it through. See you next time.